We're the Pistols. No one likes us, and we don't care.
Sid Vicious. Once upon a time, there was a little boy called Simon Beverley, and he dreamed that when he grew up, he would spit at people and never have a bath. When he did grow up, his dream came true, because a magic fairy arranged for him to be in a band called the Sex Pistols. The Sex Pistols lived in a fairyland called Out of Your Head on Drugs and Booze, and they invited many young people to come and live in the land with them. They would hold big meetings called gigs when everyone would come along wearing strange clothes and bits of metal stuck through parts of their faces and do a funny dance called pogoing when you jumped up and down and tried to break people's glasses. All these people who lived in Out of Your Head land were called punks, and they had their own special language, which involved the use of phrases like fuck off you tosser, particularly if they liked someone. Most of the young people who came to this magical land were only temporary passport holders. They were nice middle-class children, really, who thought they would be allowed in if they had a safety pin on their trousers. Besides, they only wanted to join for a bit to annoy their parents, and then they'd get a proper job. But they all looked up to the Sex Pistols, who lived the real punk life, and they wished they could be like them. The Sex Pistols were very brave. They went on television and said shit in front of millions of tea time viewers, and showed the wicked middle-aged presenter, Bill Grundy, that they meant business. Little Simon Beverley changed his name to Sid Vicious to make himself seem more scary, and he went to Paris to sing some songs and upset Parisians in the Jewish quarter by wearing a t-shirt with a swastika on it. The Parisians didn't realise that Sid was really a nice boy called Simon. He was just trying to be different. One thing the real people of punk liked doing was having a fight. Sid had lots of fights with someone called Malcolm McLaren, who, although he said he was a good friend of the punks, made lots of trips into the real world to check his bank balance. The Sex Pistols upset lots of grown-ups in England by making their own version of God Save the Queen, which had rude words in it. All the silly old people who went mad and spluttered into their morning tea didn't realise that this meant the record would sell much better and make more money for Malcolm McLaren. The boys in the Pistols decided to spread the word in America. They were very pleased with the results because there were lots of riots, and this cheered them up almost as much as having a bottle of vodka or shagging a groupie. Sid Vicious retained his crown as the most admired member of the band by stabbing himself a lot. The Sex Pistols were very pleased when a police officer said, "I have never seen anything like this shower. They seem like a bunch of dangerous escape lunatics. God knows what the kids see in them." Sid also admitted to smashing bottles and grinding them into his chest for that extra bit of teen admiration. At a gig in America, Sid was headbutted by a teenage girl called Lamar. This made Sid's face bleed, which in the Sex Pistols book is a very good thing. A roadie with the band, who lived in the real world and didn't understand, wanted to smack Lamar back. But Sid stopped him and showed his appreciation by pulling a bandage covered in pus off his arm and throwing it into the crowd. To make Sid's fairy tale world complete, all he needed was a fairy tale princess, and she arrived in the form of Nancy Spungen, whom Sid immediately fell in love with because she was a heroin addict and a go-go dancer. Sid didn't want to buy his fairy tale princess a little cottage with roses round the door. He wanted to earn enough money to pay for a birthmark to be removed from her bum so she could become a stripper. Nancy stayed in London while Sid was in America, but she wasn't wasting away dying of love for him. She was working as a prostitute to pay for her habit. Wicked Malcolm McLaren tried to stop Sid going to New York to meet Nancy and have lots of heroin, and poor Sid had to go in the bus around the southern states of America, doing gigs and cheering himself up by refusing to have a bath, cutting himself, passing out in his own vomit, and consoling himself with other women, but showing he didn't really care by covering them with diarrhea. But our fairy tale has a happy ending for Sid and Nancy. They were reunited in New York, and Sid was so pleased to see Nancy, he murdered her while they were both out of it. He was given bail and then died of an overdose in the arms of his new girlfriend. And that, children, is the story of little Simon Beverley, the Prince of Punk.